Dear students, the topic of today is the importance of resonance. The resonance, the importance. A few importance are: number one, resonance explains the bond length. It is a known fact that where there is resonance, it decreases the length of single bond but increases the length of double bond. And when resonance is absent, it makes no change in bond length. This is the funda of the bond length. Now see it with the help of examples. Example 1, the CN bond length in acetamide is shorter while this bond length is larger in ethyl amine. The answer is as accordance with the above facts. In acetamide there is resonance. First it is single bond. After resonance it becomes double bond. This becomes double bond. So this CN bond is neither the single nor the double but in between single and double bond. Whereas in case of ethylamine, conjugation absent, it means no resonance. When there is no resonance, there is no change in bond length, no change in bond length. That is, it maintains the single bond character, whereas this bond length does not maintain the single bond character, but its character is in between single and double, which we call the hybrid bond. The example 2 is in the same pattern. Example 2, carbon chlorine bond in vinyl chloride is shorter, whereas it is larger in ethyl chloride. This can be answered in accordance with the previous examples. This is vinyl chloride, conjugated molecule. It undergoes a resonance like this, generates regenerating structures like this. This double bond becomes double. Whereas it is single, resonance is effective, so the bond length is between first single and the double bond. But in case of ethyl chloride, no resonance. It maintains the single bond character. So the single bond is always larger than the hybrid bond. The another importance of resonance is stability. Number two, resonance explains the stability of aromatic carbocation. The fundamental fact regarding stability of carbocation is that a more stable carbocation is one, a more stable carbocation means larger number of resonating structures. This is the basis of this concept. See with the example. Cycloheptatrienyl cation. This is completely conjugated. And it goes resonance like this. And one more structure. Here are the five resonating structures. All are equivalent resonating structures, so contribute very effectively to the resonance hybrid, which is represented as resonance hybrid. This ion is aromatic cation, and all the five regenerating structures are equally effective. They contribute equally to the resonance hybrid, so this system is very stable. Third importance of resonances, directive influence of the substituent, or in another way, electron donation in the ring, into the ring by resonance. In other words, we call it as ortho and para directing influence of substituent. Suppose NH2 group is bonded to benzene ring, NH2 is bonded to benzene ring. Name of this molecule is aniline. It carries lone pair of electron. It pushes through the resonance here. Electron density increases at the ortho position. It delocalizes in the ring. Like this. Charge dispersal comes over here. Again it undergoes delocalization. This comes over here. The one resonating structure can be written more. This goes over here. This come back to here. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Remember that the number 1 and number 5 resonating structures are different, both are not the same. Its resonance hybrid is electron density at the ortho position is high, electron density at the para position is high, and here is slightly positive electron deficiency. This resonance hybrid suggests that this position is electron rich, this position is electron rich, and this position is electron rich. So electrophile E plus can attack at the ortho and the para position. So the NH2 group is ortho para directing. So the NH2 group is ortho and para directing substituent, para directing substituents. Because it allows the attacking electrophile at the ortho and para position during electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction. Furthermore, NH2 group is activating group. activating group because it increases the electron density on the benzene ring. And enhances the rate of substitution and enhances the rate of substitution. The another example of resonance importance is electron withdrawal from the ring. From the ring by the resonance. I put an example of nitrobenzene. This is nitrobenzene. Nitrogen is positively charged, it is directly linked to the nucleus, so it withdraws the electron towards itself, producing electron deficiency in the ring. It undergoes delocalization. It again moves over here. One more regenerating structure that comes over here. This goes to the ring. These are the resonating structures. Its resonance hybrid is deficiency in electron. Deficiency of electron. This is deficiency in electron. This is. These positions are electron deficient. This is high electron density, high electron centride. This is the same position. Attacking electrophile occupies the meta position because this position is comparatively more in electron density but less than benzene itself. With a low rate of substitution, with low rate of इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन। Thus, NO2 group is metadirecting rate of electrophilic substitution. So you can say that nitro group is metadirecting with deactivation of the ring. Resonance also explains the relative reactivity. So the fifth point is resonance explains the relative reactivity. Of molecules. For example, there are two molecules. This is the acetone, and second molecule is acetic acid. The nucleophilic addition. Nucleophilic addition takes place. Nucleophilic addition at CO is allowed. Not allowed. Because CO group in this case carries true double bond character. CO carries true double bond character. As resonance is absent. This CO lacks the double bond character. Due to presence of resonance. Due to this reason, acetone undergoes nucleophilic addition reaction while acetic acid does not. Thank you.